Alright, good. Because I want you guys to be a scientist with me, okay? So my name is Tarsha and I work as an educator here, especially with our school tours, okay? Alright? So therefore, our biggest thing is really thinking about science and thinking about our environment. So, how do we hear? We hear with our ears. And we see with our
eyes.
Exactly. So now, scientists, environmentalists, we do a lot of seeing, we do a lot of hearing, and we observe, right?
Right.
So now we're going to take about 2 minutes to be scientists. We're going to observe, and then we're going to regroup, and I'm going to ask you what you observed, okay? But before we go and do that, I want to ask you guys, when we walk up to this, it looks a little bit like a fence, but these are called balusters, okay? Balusters. And these are historic, okay? And this is a historic landmark, a historic building. So therefore, are we going to go over there and start to Superman?
No.
Are we going to go over there and Superman?
No.
No.
No, Haley.
No, we're not, okay? All right, and adults, just keep an eye, okay? We're going to make sure that we keep both feet on the
ground.
Exactly. And since this is a historic landmark, we always make sure that we are not putting our heads through because they are not being closely attacked. Adults, that's a So no heads through, all right? And so we're going to stay from this area and then over to that area. So I'll kind of going to be on that side, and then one of us here, one of us in the middle, depending on where the kids kind of cycle. Okay? So we've got about 2 minutes, and what we're going to do is then we're going to regroup, and I want to hear what my scientists, environmentalists are going to tell me, okay? What did you observe, all right?
All right.
Take a couple minutes, all right? And again, we're going to be here if you want to stay through the shade in this area as well.
Sure. Cool. Yeah. No, Haley, no Superman. Remember, both feet on the ground. Very good. Look at that. Say a little bit of algae, right? A little bit.
Algae.
Remember to tell her, she's going to ask you questions. See the pollution over there? Tell her you saw pollution.
Algae on the wall.
You see it? Yeah. The moss.
As best I can, but again, part of being outdoors.
Haley, no touching, Haley, no leaves. This must be, yeah. Come on.
All right. Oh, you got hands. Good, good girl. All right, my scientists, environmentalists, let's walk.
Over here, come on, guys. Come on, we're moving on this
Don't
way.
Worry. We got three looking points, okay?
Come on. Let's go. Come on, Brand. They're down at the waterworks again. The art museum. It was a Guinness Book of World Records contest for the kids signing, but there was so many kids, I think, that overwhelmed my kids in the heat. So we probably won't get a chance to do that yet.
We are
going to get in that fountain, yeah. After we eat our lunch, we're going to go in the fountain, or maybe before.
Huh? All right, this is our sunny spot for a minute, okay? Hang in here with me, everybody, all right? Part of being outdoor scientists, we want to be in areas where sometimes we're a little hot or we're really uncomfortable for a minute. But look this way. Look this way, everybody.
Everybody's looking this way.
All right, what do we see? We see a big hill. At the top of that hill is what? Excellent.
Very good, Kevin.
All right. So the key thing is the waterworks. It pumped water, okay? It took water straight from, what is that waterway there?
Ocean.
Not an ocean.
Schuylkill River.
See, oh, nope, not a sea. That. River, exactly. And what's the Very name? Mr.
Sherman.
Mr. Sherman just said it. What's the name of that river?
Schuylkill.
Say it again. Schuylkill River, exactly. So do you think that we would just take a cup and start drinking that water?
No.
Right? Because something is, what's wrong? Why wouldn't we do that?
Because pollution.
It's pollution and
algae in it.
Yeah, but it's okay. It's okay to have algae in it, okay? But at the same time, again, all water starts someplace, right?
Yes.
Okay, where does it come from? Where does our water come from? Say it. Exactly, she said it. And the Schuylkill River is where we get our water here in Philadelphia from, okay? but it goes to a cleaning plant. But do you guys know that the waterworks was here just pumping water? It never cleaned water. It took that water straight from the river and pumped it up that hill. All right, everybody come down. Like I said, this water was pumped straight up that big hill, okay? So let's pump ourselves up. You ready? Pump, 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 pump. And that's what was happening. It was going up that water. Now, what brings water down?
Gravity.
What did he say?
Say it again.
Gravity.
Exactly.
Very good, Kevin.
Gravity.
All right. So, okay. So the water was pumped, right? We pumped ourselves up. It got to the top of the mountain, and that art museum wasn't there. We're talking about 200 years ago, okay? So that water was clean enough 200 years ago to just drink, okay? People would just be taking it, or either we would be pumping it straight up the hill, and there's a big reservoir. A reservoir is like a big pool of water. All right, and then the water sat there, and then it went through pipes, and we're going to see one of those pipes. But what happened was, basically, what takes the water down? What forces things down? Exactly.
Loud, Kevin, what is it?
One, two, three, gravity's going to push us down. Ready? We're going to go into squatting position. One, two, three, gravity, right?
Gravity.
So that's how the water went down. It went down into these pipes. So now pump ourselves back up. Pump, 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 pump. We're at the top of the reservoir now. We're like that water, and now gravity brings us down. Okay? So I want you guys to understand that water was pumped straight from the river up the hill, and then it got into people's houses because it went down through gravity through pipes, okay? All right, let's walk. Who likes swimming?
Me.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness. All right, so now everybody put their swimming arms on.
Swimming arms, swimming arms.
Swimming, swimming,
swimming,
swimming
arms.
All of this area.
Haley, what's wrong?
Oh,
yeah, I told you.
All right, all of this. It's really like old. Like anything, but it's underneath here. So there was a swimming pool here at one point in time. All right, we have one more observation point. Let's observe our river from here. Scientists, environmentalists, again, safety, right? So let's observe along this way. We usually see a few turtles if they're out, okay?
Let's see some turtles.
Let's see if they're out, but we're gonna see what we observe, okay? This river is actually doing pretty good.
It's
our river
open.
Is actually cleaner than it has been in 100 years. So I mean,
thanks.
The water is getting cleaner. We're seeing more animals.
See the turtle?
Habitat living in it, and that means that it's getting better.
I see a crab.
It's another turtle. Where?
I see a crab right there.
Oh, right there. Crab right there.
That's something that all that.
Crab.
Yeah.
Yeah, that is a crab.
It looks see. Like a baby crab.
When it rains, the river changes. All that water.
You see the crab?
No.
Right there.
Right next to the rocks. It looks like it's dead because it's not moving at all.
Good eye, Kenya.
Okay. To keep you guys in the sun, let's walk.
Come on. We got a sun. Come on. We're doing great.
Don't run down that hill. Look at it. I don't want to get another one.
Huh?
Down that hill again.
Yeah.
I don't want to run a broken arm again.
Yeah.
Oh, I see a train.
That's good eye. Good eye. Good eye. There is a train.
And I see blue.
You see, but so remember, she's going to ask you questions when we go inside. So you saw the train, you saw pollution, you saw turtles, you saw a crab.
Golden eagle.
You saw the golden eagle. Better go on the top of the arch.
Trying to keep you guys in some shade as Thanks. We go on our Thanks. Our deck tour, okay? All right, now what have you seen so far? What have you seen? Come on, scientists. Come on, everybody. Wait a minute, hold up. Raise your hand so everybody got answers. Go ahead.
Turtle.
A turtle.
Good. All right, hold on. Just name one. All right, turtle. What'd you see?
Crab.
What'd you see?
I see crab.
Come on, Bev.
I saw the hill.
All right, good. Okay.
The hill that pumps the water.
Very
up.
Good. I love it. Good. Okay. What'd you see?
A train.
Okay, exactly, because that's our built environment, okay? Because there's part that's built and part that's natural. Go ahead.
Pollution,
exactly. That's a big one. All right, go ahead.
You saw grass, right?
Exactly.
The river. It's our river.
River.
Okay, excellent. All right. Give somebody else a turn now. All right. Anybody else have their hand up? Go ahead.
Golden eagle.
Up top. They saw it on top of the arch right there.
Oh, yes. Oh, my God.
I saw it.
Architecture. creature that's here. Excellent.
Go ahead. I spotted that at first.
The art museum. Excellent. All right. All right. I think everybody went, right?
Yep.
Now, what I want you to do, okay, back up onto the pavement for me.
Listen up, listen up.
All right.
She said back up on the pavement.
Everybody, stomp your feet. Does it sound hard or soft?
Hard.
Exactly. So, okay. Key thing is, if it's hard, right? So, if it's going to rain, because again, there's a water cycle, okay? All right? And so that river gets fed by the rain, right? So, therefore, water comes down when it rains, okay? Now, look here. My water bottle has some water in it. It's like flavored water, so it kind of has a color to it, okay? So, therefore, if I pour some of this water out onto this hard ground, is it going to soak into the ground?
No.
It's
going to dry up.
It's going to either dry up, which is evaporation, right? Or it's going to start to run, because you see it's starting to go this way, right? Huh? Sometimes water goes in different directions.
I can see a little bit of it.
Right.
Sometimes they go to
the... Exactly. Very good. A little bit of it's evaporating. But if there's a lot of water coming down, this water's going to run in different directions. So it's going to go this way. It's going to go that way. And we're in. Exactly. So therefore, say this word with me, because this is a big word and it's really important, especially as you get older and you're in school. Nope. The word that I'm going to say is green stormwater infrastructure. Green stormwater infrastructure. One more time.
Green stormwater infrastructure.
Okay, and Philadelphia is doing an excellent job in regards. It's one of the model cities for this, okay? But they're starting to build a lot of different green ways, especially in urban neighborhoods, especially in our neighborhoods. They're building these things. It may look like some big grassy pit or whatever, but at the same time, it's doing something. It's soaking up this water so that the water doesn't hit just on our neighborhood block or on our city streets and then take trash with it, because Philadelphia has a trash problem. We all know that. And then take it straight to the river, because our river is getting dirtier and dirtier based on pollution that people are putting on the street. But we need to do things to mitigate that, okay? So therefore, or stop that, I should say. And so therefore, we build things like greenery. If we have a flower garden, or you build one of those boxy ones that you can put on top of some pavement, or you can get a rain barrel. There is a rain barrel system, but we can talk more about that other stuff if you have questions on it. That's more for adults, but by all means, I want my kids to know about it. All right, so therefore, it soaks into the ground, right?
Yes.
So where would that chip bag be if there was a candy wrapper or a chip bag in the water? Would it go into our river if it landed on top of the grass? No, it would stop, so that would allow us to pick it up and clean up. Well, usually stuff, it gets trapped in the grass, so therefore that's a little bit helpful than it just running into the storm drains and into our river. All right?
Right.
All right, so we got one more step that we're going to do. Okay, let's go, Mike. Walk along this way if you're afraid of heights, you know. If you start to get a little wheezy or sick or whatever, come back over this way, okay? All right, so let's take a walk and you can look and observe, okay?
Yep. Be down there. She's talking to you. Come on down here. The girl's down here. Come on. She's gonna explain this. She slowly gets pushed down here.
Fall over, right? So therefore, if the tree falls into the river, if the river is falling down, it's
Group, Kevin.
Tots.
He's trying to get your attention. Come on, Tots, Kevin. Kevin, she wants you over here.
I love that you guys got so engaged because they weren't talking about the touch. Well, like, all right.
How do you listen? Right, she's talking.
All right, here we go. Everybody, look, we're looking this way. You see that? That's the building that we're visiting today. Fairmount Waterworks, okay? So this is a nice view of it. Now, everybody always thinks that those openings, that little circle archway there, all of those were not where the water went in. Remember, we swam through all that concrete right there. That's where the water was going in, and then the water exited out of here. So there was water that was being used to help pump water, and there was water that was being pumped up the river so that we can be fed into our households with water, okay? All right, everybody take your arm. Put it up, raise it up, all right? So now, if we were standing, and you guys, I love how you guys were pointing out this little waterfall here, right? That's a waterfall. And the reason that waterfall is there, not because of a pipe, but what do beavers build? Does anybody know?
Dams,
exactly. So that is a dam, all right? So the dam was built so that water could come around. And now, if we were standing under that waterfall, though, with our arm up, right? Arms up. If there's water coming down, would our arms stay up? It would be slowly pushed down, right? Because we can't hold all that water up. So therefore, start going like this. Push it, raising the roof, right? All right? So therefore, when you do that, that's how things
she
work.
Just told you.
So therefore, it was pushing this water back and forth so that it can push the other water up so we can get water, okay? All right. A little bit complicated, but just know this. My bottom line is there is power in water. Is there power in water?
Yes.
Yes. All right. Let's go.
Guys, come on. You got listening to the instructor. She said there's power in water. Did you understand that? Did you hear her say that? She gave you an example how you pump your arms.
All right. So therefore, did the Fairmount Waterworks, where we are now, did it clean water?
No,
it just pumped water because the water was so what?
Dirty.
No, the water was so clean, okay? Now the water is what?
Dirty.
Exactly. So now it goes to a cleaning treatment plant before it comes to our houses. But before, a long time ago, that water used to come straight from the river. But like I was saying, there's become so much pollution and trash, especially on our streets, which we won't want to happen, that our water has to be started to be cleaned, okay?
All right. So it's your trash where?
Trash.
Yep, exactly. Or what's that blue
litter.
Bin? What's the other
recycling.
One? Recycling. You got it. All right. So I want to make sure we always understand that because that's our biggest piece here. Why we want to make sure that we're showing this because this place is historical because Philadelphia cared enough, one, about its residents to make sure that water was pumped out of the river and actually distributed into households. And number two, because water is important and we always want to keep it clean. And at one point in time, this river was clean. Okay? We can't control.
We're doing a project. Isn't that nice?
Bye, you guys. It was good to see you. It was good to have you guys. All right. Have a good day.
Good night, girl. Come on over here.
Bye. It was good to see you. I'm so glad you remember me. Maybe I'll be back at Creamer. Other people are in town and visiting.
Thank you. Let's go, guys. Come on.
Yeah, this is what we do.
Let's go. Come on. Let's go, guys. Come on.
Yeah.
testing your skill? You testing your skill?
I've got the highest score on it.
You do?
Oh, let me show you something pretty cool on this. Okay.
So,
come around.
So remember outside we talked about the... talked about the dam, right? And when you build a dam, the fish can't get through. So we build a fish ladder. You heard about that before? Fish is going to talk about it. It's pretty cool. Because the fish can't get over the dam, so they have to go through something. So if you watch, it only takes, it's only... Oh, you can change it already. But if you want to, you just put the bathroom ladder and go back.
Listen, we're listening.
This is what happens when I go to the bathroom. So we're here at Fairmount Waterworks, right? So if you went to the bathroom here and you flushed the toilet, watch where it's all going to go, all right? You're right here. Come on, flush our toilet for us. Go ahead. All right, so it's starting. So you flush the toilet and it's starting to go all through these streets. Market Street, Chestnut Street, Walnut Street, all the way down. And then it goes over in Grace Ferry area, West Philadelphia. All right, and see, this is taking a long time. Do you know how long it takes for, the toilet water to get all the way to the treatment plant where it's going to be cleaned? It takes 6 hours. Can you believe that? It takes 6 hours for the toilet water to go all the way to a treatment plant. At least from here at Fairmount Waterworks, all right? It doesn't even stop. It just keeps going. But at the same time, it stops at the treatment plant. So this water then gets cleaned. Then it actually empties back into
Listen up.
And then the river, we pull from the river to bring it into a drinking water treatment plant. And then the water is clean for drinking water. So wastewater goes to one place. And then it gets put back into our river. And then from our river, we pull it again and clean it for drinking purposes. So, that makes sense? Especially
yes.
For my adults, okay? All right, let's go.
Come on, yes. What's wrong? No, we just stay focused on your tour guide. Yeah. Okay, stay focused on your tour guide. You told me three times, right?
These two are different, so if you do not put your head all the way in, but if you put your head in a little bit, you'll see. Because we talked about how the water came in through the front of the building. All the water was in here, okay? This water was not the water we were drinking. This is the water when I said it was going back and forth and it was pushing. It was pushing
look,
these water
wheels. It's pushing this water wheel. See that water wheel?
Water came in through here.
But this is
now everybody. Take your arm and start going like this. Like you're stirring a pot almost, right? So that water was being turned. So the water from here turned these wheels. Okay?
See the water wheel?
So these are, they're turbines. We didn't have water wheels. We don't have a record of the water wheel yet. But at the same time, these are the wheels. This over here was our well. So therefore, this is the water where it was held for drinking purposes. Okay? So this water was the water that we were going to be drinking. But that water over there was pushing these to make them spin so we could push the water up the hill, okay? So two different entryways, two different purposes for the water. One for power and one for drinking.
Yep.
All right,
let's go.
Going
this way.
Yeah, go ahead.
We have here more components.
No, they don't work.
Jesus Christ. We follow the tour guy. We want a tour. She's doing it for y'all to listen and learn about the waterworks. Come on. There you go.
This is the well where, so those over there, I was talking about these flumes. So you see where the tunnels are over there? And the water came in through those flumes. So that was the water that was used to power the pumps.
Yeah.
And then here's the well where other water was
Yeah.
This is the water that was being pumped. Trees will break down over time, right? Especially if we're putting them back underground and water is going through them, right?
Right.
So they wouldn't last. So that's why we started to use metal and steel and all kinds of other equipment and things like that to build our pipes. All right, let's go.
Okay.